What's up, ladies and gentlemen of the internet? Crowfall is finally moving into its beta phase, and that means a lot of people are going to be playing the game for the very first time. As things tend to get a bit overwhelming as a new player, I thought it'd be a good idea to start throwing out some videos that covered some crucial information about it. Hopefully that will give people a better insight to how they want to approach things and build up their playstyle. As this game does demand you to make quite some permanent choices right from the get-go, you might want to consider these things. I'm Shadiz, I stream about 3 days a week on Twitch, link is in the description below, and I upload new videos on YouTube on a weekly basis. Without further ado though, let's get into this. Here's my 5 points of advice or tips you should probably consider when starting out as a new player in Crowfall. The very first thing you want to consider is what type of class you want to be playing, or race. I'm not only talking about combat, even if you want to become a pure crafter, your class and race will impact your stats here. For example, having a skinner will do much better if you have a race that has an increase in dexterity, because dexterity gives you better skinning abilities. This might sound like a no-brainer to most of you, but here's why it's so important to have a clear vision of what you want to become. Building up a decent and competitive character takes a lot of time, effort, and social interaction with others. Sure, you can easily level up a new class to level 30 in a matter of hours or even faster, but gearing that character with the right stats and so forth can set you back quite a bit. Especially at the start of a game where resources are scarce and people haven't leveled up their crafting skills yet. But that's not the most important reason why you should seriously consider your choices here. Passive training is a major and permanent part of the game, which will dictate what exactly you'll be able to do and excel at. This also brings us to our second point, understanding the passive training system. Passive training is a type of skill system akin to EVE Online. Yes, for you guys, this is going to be second nature. Here, you allocate training time towards increasing your direct combat stats, crafting skills, or exploration slash gathering capabilities, which you accumulate both while being online and offline. The choices you make here are permanent, so no respecs, rerolls, or redos here, people. What you choose is what you get. To give you an idea, passive training into the combat tree makes up for about roughly 1/5 of your character's stats. I'm not going to go into too much detail in this video, I'll be making a separate quick guide that covers this system in depth, so keep your eyes open for that, or if you're watching this when I already made it, there should be a link on the screen towards that piece of content somewhere. Let me give you a quick breakdown though. So at any given time, you can be training 2 separate training tracks in one of the 3 major skills: combat, crafting, and exploration. So you're going to have to make a big choice here. You also won't be able to double dip in any of these 3s. That means you won't be able to level both tracks into the combat tree, for example. A lot of people think combat is the absolute must-have, but that's not entirely true. Imagine if you want to become a really amazing crafter. Leveling up both crafting and exploration will make you a lot more efficient because it allows you to go out and gather your own materials a lot faster. The point I'm making here is spend some time thinking about and mapping out your passive training route so that you can avoid making permanent choices you might later regret. Because keep in mind, everything that you choose in the passive training is account-wide, so you only have one shot at choosing where you want to put points into, and that will be true for all the other characters you will make from here on out. On to point number 3, and this is probably, for me personally, the most important one to consider, and that is find a guild or dedicated group of friends to play with. I can't stress enough, and everyone that has been playing Crowfall says the same thing. This game is not a solo player experience. You cannot do anything by yourself in this game. You're gonna wanna have people to rely on, that can make you crafting materials, that can go out with you and cover you while you're gathering, all kinds of stuff. Everything in this game is hand and player made. So that means even if you are, for example, a very good blacksmith, you're still gonna have to rely on a lot of leather workers to make straps for your plates, gatherers to go and get the ores, you need combatants to cover you while you're crafting so you don't get ganked while mid-craft. All those kind of things all accumulate towards group play. So having a group of people to have your back is oh so important. There's not a lot to say about this. just be social. Be a social butterfly. It has to happen. You're playing an MMO. Do it. If you're still looking for a guild, the best way to do so is to go to the Crowfall website, and there under the tab guilds, you can search for guilds like this. And here you can type in just the name of the guild you're searching for, or you can put in some advanced criteria. Let me show you the guild I have joined so far as of late, which is called Caldera. They have been around since whenever I started playing the game in 2016, so we've been going on for quite a while, and as you can see here on the screen, you can see a little bit of information about the guild, who the ranking officers are, and then here you can request to join the guild and you will be put up for evaluation. So if you want, our recruitment is also open, feel free to check us out, and I just want you to find a guild, guys. Find a good group to play with and have fun in the game. So now that we talked about the things you should do before you log into the game, let's talk about your first few hours into the game and preparing for campaigns. So what do you do once you first log in? What's the purpose? As of late, there's been a new player experience patched into the game, which is a series of quests that will teach you the basics of gathering, crafting, and building. You want to work yourself through these quick and easy quests, and that will most likely get you to about level 17. From there, you're on your own. At this point, you could go to a campaign map where PvP is enabled, but if this is your very first time, you should probably consider just leveling up your character to level 30 and stockpiling a few basic necessities like food and bandages before stepping into the campaign, as PvP in this game comes with player looting, meaning whatever you got in your inventory as you die can be looted by others except for the gear you currently have equipped. So even if you're not a crafter, you'll still be crafting quite a bit of basic recipes. Think of it as a kind of crafting akin to survival games. You'll be able to craft bandages, gathering tools, and food that replenish your food meter. Basic weapons so that you can at least start smacking wet noodles at things. Now that we've covered this, you should be ready to head into the campaign and go have some fun. If you want to learn more in-depth stuff about the game, a few good places to go look for information are the forums or checking out some of the longtime Crowfall streamers and asking them your questions. I will be streaming Crowfall again this Wednesday, so feel free to come in and ask your questions. As I said before, I'll be putting out a bunch of these short bite-sized quick guide videos over the coming few weeks, so keep an eye out for them, and if you have any value out of this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. If you have any questions, feel free to comment in the video, and I'll try to answer them for you. The Crowfall community has always been a very helpful one. This is one of the reasons why I've been enjoying this game over the last few years. It's probably the most welcoming and helpful community I've experienced in any early stage MMO alpha testing that I've been a part of to date. Except for the bastards that keep killing me and looting me dry, by the way. Yes, I know who you are and I will find you. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it for today. Have an awesome day and hopefully you'll enjoy Crowfall in this coming beta phase. Until later!